This protest may not know where its leader is or what happens next, but it isn't going anywhere. In the fierce heat of the Ramadan fast, protest simmers at the ousting of President Morsi by Egypt's generals in a fast-built community where everything has a political message. Ayman Shaheen travelled 80 kilometres to be part of this and says he'll live here until victory. The barricades have grown, staggered along key roads. They roam past the Defence Ministry before the army's new lines. Soldiers facing calm Islamists in a country split. One reading the Quran, another not. Days ago, over 50 were shot dead nearby. Their shoes a reminder of the violence that could return.
Well, the numbers of protesters may ebb and flow, but this barricade has taken on an almost permanent nature in the last 24 hours. And given that it sits here on this vital route near government buildings, the key question is how long will the army let this standoff endure?
Washington wants the army's politically motivated arrests to stop, but here the men they want move freely, sheltered by their supporters.
Why didn't you tell them to go home for their own sakes?
They are no longer affected by the fear of being killed or arrested, he says. These people are not Muslim brothers. These millions have taken a stand on principle. They will either live under the umbrella of a civilian democratic nation or they'll take their last breaths. They will not accept in any way this military rule. Outside, a man in a conspicuous smart suit is suddenly chased by protesters. They try to beat him, saying he's an army spy. They won't let us film, and it's unclear what happens to the man.
Bad, bad, bad man.
The calm and civility evaporates briefly but fast. Nick Payton-Walsh, CNN, Cairo.